There's a story, there's a song, sleeping in the shadows, reminding where you belong. There was a man, there was a woman, inside them a raw feeling. It remains, it remains unsung.
Reciting the Quran is like music to my ears.
Praying veil is just my spiritual side. The other side is I start listening to extreme music during my teen years. I find it kind of interest to my soul. Even though it sounds extreme, but it doesn't mean that it's bad. Of course, there's conflicts because to play extreme music, like for Muslim, it's very contradicting. You don't see any female musician playing with a veil.
I wrote a song, Fairy Tales. This is our newest song. It's about children suffering in Syria and Palestine. Over there is sufferings and pain that you can't even imagine that a child can even endure that. So that gives me the inspiration of writing Fairy Tales.
I consider myself a musician. That's my number one love.
To the layman, you look at Kiang, he's just, you know, an ordinary uncle. But to a musician, I would say cult status. During his heyday, he was huge. He was from this band, Stray Dogs. They were revolutionary, you see. They have been credited as pioneers of the blues, rock, R&B scene in Singapore, right? If you go to like the EMI Harvest catalog, you know, out of all the UK bands, you can see Stray Dogs Singapore, 1970-something. It's right there.
Well, the band started when we had a group of guys that just hang out. We are like a pack of dogs, and someone came along and said, why don't you call yourselves the Stray Dogs? On to the Blues is about my daily routine in Katong, what I do almost every day when I was young. Walk the streets and stuff like that. Whenever I think of this song, it brings back memories. It reminds me of what it used to be.
Three children, age 2, 8, and 10. Being in a band as a musician and at the same time being a mother, of course there's challenges. My son is always like in and out of hospital, so it's kind of tough for chronic lung disease children. So as how much I can stay in the band is like, I will do it.
Words of love, buried but forgotten, not unearthed in the universe.
Waiting to board the bus for Subang Jaya. I'm going there to meet friend of mine called Marco. We're trying to work some parts out from the album. The music has always remained with me for 15 years, and we are only guaranteed our next breath. So I better do the album before something happens to me.
We are like a family, you know, like father and son. I follow his idea to finalize his album and all the feelings he have inside in his heart, what he wants to say to the Singaporean people and to the world.
My family is a big part of my life because they've encouraged me. The music that I wrote is a way to communicate, probably with my daughter, to let her know what her daddy went through when he was young. The music does speak like what I feel. Sometimes I don't say it in words, maybe I say it in the song.
Tariq got admitted yesterday. We did not bring any of his stuff. So now I'm like rushing to put in all his things. I know I'm having a gig coming up, but I can't really practice in the hospital. So the thing will be hold on for a while until he's really cured. The best one runs up the struggle.
I'm going to have a jam session with Marco and some musicians and enjoy the night. I should be pretty well received.
1, 2, 3, 4.
We're having an argument because the musicians that were supposed to show up did not. Apparently, they were having another performance somewhere that is paying, so they didn't come.
But you just have to do what you set out to do and just play.
Heading to Malaysia JB. We're having a gig at Embrace Hall. This gig is important because it's the first gig that we actually had for a very long time. My son is well now. He just got discharged and he's doing much better now.
This is it, our EP, okay? 20 years, okay?
It's interesting because we get to go as a band together, travel in a van. Feeling like a rock star.
But I can't wait to rock out later.
I've been following OU for almost 20 over years. I've been bringing my daughter to every show, every gig, and to tell her who is OU.
I thought that women can play that kind of genre, you know, hardcore. But then they proved me wrong.
Tonight was amazing. I did not expect such a good response. We brought 30 pieces and like we are left with 5 now. One or two also ask for our signatures and all that, like, wow, we feel a bit rockstar.
I like to hear my mother's music. I always go for her gigs. I think my mother is cool.
This is just the beginning of Obstacle Upset. Friendship is what makes Obstacle all the way.
That's what makes obstacles stand strong. I know sometimes it's very difficult, it's very tough, but it's how you handle it, how you face it.
The rather real, she's still and brave, steadfast in the chaos, in the music she saved. The road, the dreams, he's the rhythm and blues. It might be unspoken, but it rings fierce and true. So don't let your song be unsung. The bends, the highs, the deeps and downs, you ought to be lost before you're found. The wise, the weak, no one makes it out unharmed. You might be older, but your heart's still young. So don't let your song be unsung. Your song be unsung.